First of all, I would like to extend my gratitude and thanks to be allowed to be part of these programs. I have the opportunity to address my short lecture with the topic given to me to deliver entitled Legal Protection of Forests in Indonesia. Legal protection of forests in Indonesia should be approached with two levels, policy level and law enforcement level. The law cannot be enforced effectively without strong and capable institutions. Policy making is essential by strengthening the human resources and organizational structure, not merely focusing on the legal framework approach. Policy level of the court. The amendment of the Constitution of the Republic of Indonesia through Article 28H indicating Indonesia as having green constitutions, which is clearly defined and guaranteed that healthy environment is the right of the people. The strong message is then followed by the enactment of series of laws. Responding to the new atmosphere, the Indonesian judiciary, especially the Supreme Court of the Republic of Indonesia, must create the green bench and green judges. With regard to this, the Asian Development Bank has significantly helped Indonesia by establishing judicial certification training program for judges on environmental law in collaborations with the Supreme Court of the Republic of Indonesia. And it is also assisting the Ministry of Environment and the Supreme Court as we develop one roof enforcement system to coordinate the entire environmental law compliance and enforcement chains within the related government institution without interfering the independence of each institution. The Supreme Court also established National Judicial Working Group on Environment, which its main task is to monitor and evaluate the implementation of the program and submit any input to the leadership of the Supreme Court for the future policy making on environment, including updating and revising the teaching material based on emerging changes and issues. In 2008, Judicial Training Center released a training book policy which mainly revealed that we have several kinds of training. Initial training for candidate judges and continuing judicial education for judges with the working work of 5 years and continuing judicial education with the working experience of 10 years. And we also have a refreshment course. And finally, we have the certification training program for judges. There are two kinds of judicial certification training program for judges. Firstly, which is mandatory or obligatory by law. Secondly, which is deemed important by the Supreme Court. The judicial certification training program for judges on environment is included in second category. Any judges who will hear the case on environment have to undergo judicial certification training program on environment. Those judges who pass the exam at the end of the training, whom would be then certified and qualified and appointed by the Chief Justice as the environmental judges. During the judicial training program, judges is not merely equipped with knowledge and skill, but also enhance their sensitivity and passion to nature. Encourage judges to deliver justice on the basis of judicial activism and pro natura to protect forests and environment. A pool of trainers is maintained by Judicial Training Center or Judicial Academy, comprising of justices, senior judges, academia, experts, and other professionals. Teaching material are developed by the trainers based on training need analysis or assessment. Trainers involved in training of trainers or TOT, and any trainers who are not able to deliver teaching material can only be replaced by those who are listed in the Judicial Training Center. Training is held with adult learning methodology. E-learning is developed as well to reach beyond remote areas, since Indonesia is a vast country with thousands of islands. For the sustainability of the Judicial Certification Training Program, for judges on environment, fund is allocated annually and a certain number of judges are targeted. A part of those mentioned above effort in a series of justice decrees and Supreme Court circular are issued to implement further related law and regulation. Within the period of 6 years, a number of Chief Justice decrees and Supreme Court circular are amended to respond to emerging changes and circumstances. Law enforcement level. Consistent implementation of the Judicial Certification Training Program on Environment for Judges and other policy is paid off in enforcing the law. Some high-profile cases on forest fire are brought to justice both in criminal and civil matters. In civil matters, judges impose huge amount of money to the defendant whom considered to violate the law number 32 year 2009 on environment and qualified as doing tort causing any damages, so the defendant are liable to pay losses and costs of restoration. Most cases involving forests in Indonesia are illegal logging and forest fire, more specifically, peat-based forest fire. Peat-based forest fire is complicated, costly, irreparable, and lead to profound implications with the consequences of involving the implementation of scientific evidence, including satellite image. The density and complexity of the scientific evidence make it difficult for judges to cull the legal issues from sophisticated scientific evidence. Assessing the damages and determining losses and cost of the restoration is the most difficult thing in enforcing the law on environment, especially in peat-based forest fire. So the judges must rely on the expert research and report as elaborated in the ministerial regulation of the Ministry of Environment, number 7, year 2014, which stipulate and contain quantifications of ecological damages and economic valuations. Currently, the Indonesian court have challenges on how to execute and exercise court judgments ordering the defendant to pay or to do the restoration. There is no scheme of restoration in place to deal with the issues. Encountering these challenges, the National Judicial Working Group on Environment tried to identify the issues and challenges by holding a workshop presenting some experts from Environmental Law Institute. We are in the process of making roadmap of searching the format and scheme of restoration which is suitable and applicable under Indonesian legal system. Bearing in mind restoration involving huge amount of money, long-term executions, and public participation, because public is the most vulnerable and worst affected by the forest fire. Law enforcement level need independent professional judges with full integrity. That's all my short lecture. Hopefully this brief information on the current progress in developing our green court in this face-to-face meeting of Global Judicial Institute on Environment is fruitful. Thank you very much.